And do the announcements.
We would like to welcome you to our church family. We will open with an opening prayer.
Okay, let's bow our heads.
Dear God, thank you for this wonderful days that we've had at this church. Thank you for all the people that came to learn about you with us. This is a wonderful day to be here. In Jesus' name, amen.
We'll be singing Jesus Loves Me. He knows it by heart. We can just sing it by heart. It's not in there.
Ben.
Now we're going to take the fruit of the vine. Take the lid off. Okay. Rowan, take your mask off.
Thank you for being here tonight. I would like to talk about some of the things we have learned this quarter. If you'd like to follow along with me, I'll be reading from Exodus 20:12. Honor your father and your mother, that your days may be long upon the land which the Lord your God is giving you. When you obey your parents, that's something you are doing for them, but you're also doing it for God. It's like you're actually obeying Him and working for Him. What does it mean to obey your parents? Well, let me give you an example. When mommy or daddy say to clean up your room, you obey them by cleaning up your room, and you want to do a good job because you're doing it for God too. Next, turn with me to Ephesians 6:4. Fathers, do not provoke your children to anger, but bring them up in the discipline and instruction of the Lord. And now turn with me to 1 Timothy 2:8-9. I desire therefore that men pray everywhere, lifting up holy hands without wrath and doubting, in like manner also, that the women adorn themselves in modest apparel, with propriety and moderation, not with braided hair, or gold, or pearls, or costly clothing. And once more, turn with me to Titus 2:4-6, so that they may encourage the young women to love their husband, to love their children, to be sensible, pure, workers at home, kind, being subject to their own husbands, so that the word of God may not be dishonored. Likewise, exhort the young men to be sober-minded. When the Bible mentions that mommies are to love their children and husbands, because of it, when they do that, they are showing love to God. For example, I know my mommy loves me when she cooks food for me, helps me in the many different ways, and reads to me. Also, fathers need to teach their children right and wrong, and bring them up in their nature and to always pray. For example, daddy should teach your kids not to do bad things like lying and disobeying. Finally, turn with me to Hebrews 10:24-25. And let us consider one another to stir up love and good works, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. This verse talks about our church family and the benefit of going to church, like worshiping, praying, and singing to God, and learning about the Bible. This verse also talks about encouraging each other so we can all go to heaven.
Okay. Go ahead and stand up and sing our song. Everybody stand. Take your mask off, Noah. Can you start it? We are bound for Canaan's land, tempting by the way. Who shall lead us on the road? Choose your king today. Dare to stand like Joshua. Dare to say the word. As for me and for my house, we will serve the Lord. Okay, we're at the close. Dominic, closing prayer.
Dear God, thank you for this day, and thank you for what you've given us, and please protect us, and please give us wisdom, and help us not sin. In Jesus' name, amen.